unkind word for Rick Steiner. There's a good look at the dog-faced gremlin. Fans, want to remind you, the next pay-per-view spectacular, brought to you by World Championship Wrestling and Turner Home Entertainment, will be Sunday afternoon, July 23rd, 4:30 Eastern Time in Baltimore at the Baltimore Arena. We encourage you, if you cannot be with us in Baltimore live, to call your local cable company now for program availability. Nice football tackle. Deep fireman carry takeover, taking the big man off his feet, negating his strength advantage here with Scotty Steiner. Right into the arm bar. Tremendous muscular definition of Scott Steiner. Both these Steiner brothers are tremendously gifted athletes. Scott Steiner has a degree in education. And the education now is being taught by the bounty hunter, but a nice reversal. Great agility for this kid. Look at this move. Flying head scissor takes him over. Oh, what a great move. And the bounty hunter came dangerously close to Rick Steiner. Again, fans, the big event in Baltimore, which is our host city for the Great American Bash, will be Sunday afternoon, July 23rd, 4:30 Eastern Time. Call your local cable company for program availability. Only two ways you'll be able to see this tremendous event. That is to be in Baltimore live or to see it as it happens in the comfort of your own home. There will be no highlights of this event shown on home television. Terry Funk and Ric Flair, Luger and Steamboat for the U.S. title. The Stinger in a great mood for the television championship. And of course, Jim Cornette and Paul E. Dangerously finally will settle their situation in a one-time only sanctioned event that will be only in Baltimore and only on Sunday afternoon, July 23rd, again starting at 4:30 Eastern Time. Armbar applied by Scott Steiner, but the big bounty hunter rises to a vertical base and opens up for the barrage of right hand. Good reversal by Steiner and a nice drop kick. Caught him right in the kisser. These masked men, you can't really tell a lot about their emotion or how much pain they're in because the mask covers their facial expression. And I think you can hear that the bounty hunter is indeed a high degree of pain right now from the reverse chin lock. And the dog-faced gremlin. Everything's looking great for him. He's got a new girlfriend. We met her, Robin Green. And also, fans, the Steiners will be at the post-Great American Bash event in Baltimore against Captain Mike Rotunda and Kevin Sullivan in a Texas Tornado tag match. That's where all four men are in the ring at the same time. There'll be no tagging in that event. Bounty hunter now, the knee to the midsection. Big right hand and another big right. Bounty hunter buries the left foot to the midsection, follows it with a right hand. Irish whipping Scotty Steiner, and Steiner went for the high risk. He nailed a couple of flying moves, great head scissor earlier than a drop kick, but he missed that one. And now can the bounty hunter take over? He's going straight for the power moves. Big backbreaker. Steiner in trouble. One, two, and the shoulder, the right shoulder is up. I want to remind the fans to join us tomorrow night, 6:05 Eastern Time for World Championship Wrestling, and Sunday night at 6:05 for the NWA main event right here on Superstation TBS. And right there, the bounty hunter, that big oversized foot squarely in the throat of Scott Steiner. Boy, there's some great action tomorrow night in the Boston Garden. Great American Bash on tour in the Boston Garden tomorrow night. And Steiner, who looks to be out on his feet, was tossed out of the ring, and Big Brother has come to the ring. He doesn't like the officiating. He doesn't like the tactics specifically of the bounty hunter. Scotty Steiner met as he got on the apron by the bounty hunter. Johnny Hunter with another slam. It's almost as if he's grasping for more high-impact maneuvers to deliver on Scott Steiner. One, two, and a near fall predicament. And Scotty Steiner comes up fighting. Steiner inside cradle. One, two, but he couldn't hold him. The man's too strong. Side headlock now. And a takeover by the masked man. Nature Boy Ric Flair and Terry Funk. It has been signed. Flair will go from May 7th to July 23rd before he makes his return to the ring. And I'm sure all the fans in Baltimore feel excited, and as we do, about being in that tremendous city. Man, the Baltimore Orioles are red hot. Turned it completely around. Great work by manager Frank Robinson. We look forward to being in Baltimore. Sunset flip, one, and only one. Mother's Valley Hunter's a big, strong individual clothesline. He may have him here. One, two, the foot on the rope. We'll stop the count. We'll be hearing from Nature Boy Ric Flair live tomorrow at 6:05 Eastern Time. The Nature Boy will be with us live tomorrow here on the Superstation. Remember, 6:05 Saturday and Sunday for the action here on Superstation TBS. Snap mare applied by the bounty hunter right into the reverse chin lock on Scott Steiner. Steiner chose to come to pro wrestling as opposed to being a secondary education teacher. Both he and brother Rick enjoy being around kids. Donate their time a great deal to the nonprofit groups and organizations involving these youngsters. And Scotty Steiner tried to mount the attack. Bounty Hunter took a shortcut, pulled the tights, and took him off his feet. Well, I wonder what Paul E. Dangerously and Terry Funk are going to talk about tonight in Funk's Grill. Of course, Dangerously's got to be training. You can call, watching an exercise bike go around and around training, but he's getting ready for Jim Cornette on July 23rd in Baltimore. Once again, the bounty hunter takes a shortcut. Tommy Young asking the bounty hunter if he pulled his tights, and as is custom to form, he denied it. I've never seen a man admit that he pulled tights if he was asked, and he did it. Bounty hunter now opening back up. This is just like a street fight for him. He wants to keep it brawling. Big powerful slam. Going for the big splash. Nobody home on that one. Misses with the elbow. Steiner's quickness coming to the front here. Clothesline glanced right off the top of his head. And now Scotty Steiner back up. The conditioning showing what it's all about here. What a tremendous move. That reverse slam, and this one's over. And they're barking here, the winner of the match.
Winner of the match from Michigan, Scott Steiner.
Scott Steiner, the winner here on the Power Hour. And now let's go back to Jim Cornette.
A guy they're predicting a lot of big things for in the future, Scott Steiner, one of the Steiner brothers. And don't go away. Be sure and stay tuned, because the Wrestling News Network with Gordon Solie is next.
For wrestling's most important network, the Power Hour presents the Wrestling News Network. Now let's go to the Walter Cronkite of Wrestling, Gordon Solie.
Welcome to the Wrestling News Network. As I predicted last week on the Power Hour, Ric Flair did make his announcement and is returning to professional wrestling. He will be defending his NWA title against the former NWA champion, Terry Funk, on July 23rd. One question in my mind, however: is Ric Flair 100%? I guess we'll find out on the 23rd. Also in Baltimore, Sting has signed to defend his TV title against the great Muta. Now, Eddie Gilbert will be in Sting's corner. And Rick Steamboat is extremely upset. He has a special challenge out for Lex Luger. That challenge will be announced tomorrow night on World Championship Wrestling. And finally, for those of you fortunate enough to be in the Baltimore area, here are some exclusives upcoming for you for the Great American Bash in Baltimore. First of all, you will be seeing Ric Flair defending his title against Terry Funk. You will see Jim Cornette against Paul E. Dangerously in a tuxedo match. The only way you can lose is to have that tuxedo completely stripped from your body. You'll also see the War Games 89 and the finals of the Triple Crown. In other wrestling news, let's go now to the WWF. A most unusual situation occurred this past week. As you know, Rick Rude is internationally famous for delivering the Rude Awakening to pretty young damsels. Well, this past week, he decided it was time for some young damsel to give him a Rude Awakening instead. The Ultimate Warrior charged into the ring and gave Mr. Rude what he called the Ultimate Awakening. Turning now to international news, let's go to Japan. Antonio Inoki, a longtime legend in Japan, has been injured. He has required surgery on his shoulder and is now retired from professional wrestling. Rumor has it, he's going to run for public office. And on another medical note, here in the United States, Jerry Crusher Blackwell is recovering from pneumonia. We certainly wish him the very, very best. And speaking of Southern wrestling, the new tag team champions are the Georgia Power. They defeated Kent's Dynasty, and they're taking on all challengers. Coming up next, the top 10. This is the official NWA top 10 list. In number 10 position, Tommy Wildfire Rich. Number 9, Dick Murdoch. Number 8, Eddie Gilbert. Number 7, Dr. Death. Number 6, Terry Gordy. Number 5, the Great Muta. Number 4, Terry Funk. Number 3, the Sting. Number 2, Lex Luger. Number 1, Rick Steamboat. And of course, the official NWA World Heavyweight Champion is Ric Flair. And now a personal note, if you please. My commentary this week concerns the Great Muta, who has yet to be pinned in the NWA. He's a master of the martial arts. He is a consummate athlete. There's certainly no question about that. But will his unbroken record of victories be marred when he meets Sting on the 23rd in Baltimore? I guess we'll have to wait and find out. And that's the way it is on the Wrestling News Network. I'm Gordon Solie.
I want him to give the weather, the wrestling weather. We got to have
I'll tell you what, he rounds everything else in the world of wrestling up, and I mean in the world of professional wrestling.
Tommy Rich is coming up next. You know a lot about Tommy Rich.
Tommy Rich, a young man originally from Hendersonville, Tennessee, spent a lot of the past several years in Atlanta, where he's a big favorite. And I know Tommy, I've known him for a long time. He was a professional at the age of 17. He was a worldwide star at the age of 21. He was the NWA heavyweight champion of the world at the age of 23. And now he's not yet 30, but he's a seasoned veteran looking in the best shape of his career. And he's coming back to make a march on the NWA title.
And fans, let's see Tommy Rich in action. Let's go to the ring. Wildfire is next.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be one fall. Introducing first of all to my left, from Stone Mountain, Georgia, Big Jim Bryan. And his opponent, from Atlanta, Georgia, please welcome Tommy Wildfire Rich!
Tommy Rich returning to the NWA to challenge Big Jim Bryan, a 325-pounder. And Wildfire will certainly have his work cut out for him in moving this big man around. Tommy Rich powers Bryan back into the corner. Another collar and elbow tie up, and Rich trying to get underneath Bryan, pushed him back into the corner. Tommy Rich was one of the most, one of the shortest fuses in the sport. He boils in a hurry, and he enjoys the fisticuffs. He's a brawler, and will fight you. Nice arm drag takeover. Quickly back up to his feet is Tommy Rich. He's got a hit and run, uses wrestling expertise. Nice front toe hold by Rich. Floats over Big Jim Bryan into a front face lock. Rich staying above and in control of Bryant. Found his mark right on the jaw. Rich sent for the ride, and then Bryant kicked him with a big elbow. And Rich finally goes down, trying to keep his balance a bit. And Rich fighting back. Big elbow. Backs Bryant up, sends him for the ride. Kicked him with an elbow coming off the ropes. And Tommy Wildfire Rich now reasserting himself in this match with that big power knee lift. Rich back to reestablish himself in the NWA. At one time, one of the most popular figures ever in the NWA. And now he's back, and he wants to regain that brilliance that took him to stardom. He's a young man, probably in his late 20s. The reverse is a good look at the handsome youngster now living in Atlanta, Georgia. Originally from Tennessee, I think. Headlock. Rich tenacious with that maneuver as Big Jim Bryant leans on him. And a cheap shot there downstairs. Rich in for the ride. Bryant misses with the elbow. And Rich with a big right hand. That just flattened the 300 pounder. Clubbing blow right to the head. Rich with a lateral press. 1-2. And back to the reverse chin lock on a man that's got to outweigh Tommy some 60 pounds. But when you got your opponent in that position, size is really of little consequence. Rick picks him up. And neckbreaker, down he goes. What a move. What an offensive move by Tommy Rich. And Big Jim Bryant may be on his way out. 1-2, but the big man powers out. Rich now sends him for another ride. Oh, downstairs. Powerful right hand. He buried it. Elbow right to the top of the head. And a right hand straight to the nose. Rich likes to brawl. Wild and crazy is the way he likes it. Busy for the ride. Rich with a drop kick. Nice move. Rich with a drop and a lateral press. Back into the reverse chin lock. Tommy Rich.
How about it, Bryant?
With a tremendous reputation, fans far and wide know this man's abilities, of his track record. He's been in the ring with the greatest that the sport has to offer.
Oh. Hold that hair now.
Rich. Throwing that temper and pulling a little hair there. By the foot, that's legal. Right below the heart of Big Jim Bryant. Nice reversal by the big man. Rich, though, too quick for it. Blackrock's by that fast pass. Can he hold him down? Yes, he can.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Tommy Wildfire Rich.
Tommy Rich back in the NWA with victory number one here on television under his belt. Wants to recapture that magic, and he certainly looks like he is capable of doing that here. The loose ends pressed. Nowhere to go for Jim Bryant, but down. Tommy Rich is a winner, and we'll be back.
Well, you saw Tommy Rich with another victory, and stay tuned for Funk's Grill with his special guest, Paulie Dangerously. And Paulie, I just want to say, if you think it's hot at the grill, wait till July 23rd in Baltimore, Maryland, brother. You're going to have a light under your rear end like you ain't never seen in a long time, courtesy of James E. Cornette. We'll be right back.
To visit the most unpredictable place in wrestling, let's go to Funk's Grill.
Hey, I want to give all of you young kids out there a little lesson in grammar. You see that apostrophe there in Funks? That means possession. This is my show, and I can invite whoever I want to Funk's Grill. And today, I am going to invite out none other than Paul E. Dangerously.
Such an honor to be here on this show with you, Terry Funk. I can't tell you what a privilege. I am humbled to be here on Funk's Grill. As a matter of fact,
well, wait one second. Since I invited you here, could I possibly be on the Danger Zone?
Yes, you could be on the Danger Zone tomorrow night. I tell you what, not only that, but, you know, I happen to be the host of the Sunday show here on TBS. Would you come and be my guest on the Sunday show as well?
Well, doggone it, Paulie, I don't.
Come on. I got a surprise for you. I got a surprise for you. I've been practicing this all week. I want you to watch this. Are you ready?
I am the man that has paid his toll. I will kill Ric Flair and rock and roll.
How's that? Isn't that great?
I know who you're doing.
Yes!
I know who that is.
Who is it?
That's my Uncle Herman.
No.
You know...
Yes, again.
Was it a politician? Is it a politician?
It's better than a politician. He can play politics, but he doesn't have to. He's that great of a man.
It's not Senator Sarpolis.
No, it's not the senator. Guess who it is?
Is he a winner?
Oh, the ultimate winner.
Amarillo Slim.
No.
The gambler.
No, it's you.
Oh, doggone it, Paulie. You're kidding
me. The next heavyweight champion of the world. Terry Funk.
On the 23rd.
On the 23rd.
You know, I want to tell you something. After I win that world championship, I want to sit back in a chair and I want to watch the high-risk performers. And who are the high-risk performers?
The Samoan SWAT team. The greatest team in the history of professional wrestling.
Take more risk than any other wrestler in professional wrestling are the Samoan SWAT team.
Well, I tell you what, Terry.
But there's one guy that is approaching a bigger risk than what the Samoan SWAT team takes. He is going to be sticking his neck out on the 23rd. And I am talking about none other than old Banana Nose, old Horse Tooth.
Woo! Yeah,
you got
him.
It.
Yeah, Ric Flair, huh? He wants to be the biggest shot in professional wrestling history. He thinks he can stop you from your destiny.
You know, the 23rd that night, I'm going to change that woo to a moo whenever I take that branding iron and put it down on him. And what am I going to do? It's going to be the double cross.
The double. You're great.
You are too, Paulie.
Thank you.
Well, wasn't that fun? Funk's Grill with Paulie Dangerously. Paulie, you've been hanging over my head like elective surgery for a long time now. But after the 23rd, all that's going to be rectified. Now stay tuned for our main event. Coming up now on the hottest hour in wrestling, the NWA Power Hour.
Let's go to the arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be six-man tag team action. Introducing first of all from Amarillo, Texas, Wild Bill Irwin. His partners from Auckland, New Zealand. Ladies and gentlemen, the New Zealand Militia. And their opponents, now making their way to the ring. First of all, introducing Brian Pillman and his partners. Now making their way to the ring, the Dynamic Dudes, Johnny and Shane.
Six-man tag team action here, fans. It ought to be a fast-paced encounter, no doubt. The Dynamic Dudes and Flying Brian. Where do you see Shane of the Dudes? They're called the unorthodox trio of Wild Bill Irwin and the even wilder New Zealand Militia.
Lion Bryan, Johnny and Shane against the big team of the New Zealand Militia and Wild Bill Irwin. There's 6 men in the ring now. Looks pretty full. You put 25 or 30 in there starting out against these in these two ring triple chance battle royals. Two rings setting side by side. Everybody starting in the ring A, and after being eliminated from ring A, except for one man over the top rope to ring B, the 28 or 29 remaining will wrestle in ring B until everyone's been over the top rope, until there's only one left. Gonna really be something. 25 to 30 athletes, two rings setting side by side. Triple chance battle royal. $25,000 goes to the winner during the Great American Bash Tour. Jocko Victory is starting to take on some of the characteristics and mannerisms of the men from down under. Starts off quickly against Shane. High impact right hand. Lands his head into the top turnbuckle. Nothing pretty about the Militia thus far. High elevation for Shane. Nice drop kick. And Pilner with a headbutt. Jocko is in trouble. And he will escape to the outside. You know what they're saying. I don't know if you can figure it out. Let me know.
Six, seven.
Nick Patrick exercising his count. Got to eight on that one. Two more and they would be counted out. Dollar and elbow tie-up. Jocko with the advantage. Big elbow. This team of the Militia and Irwin certainly got the advantage with size. We'll see if the dudes in Flying Bryan can offset it with some speed. Back to eight. Here comes Wild Bill, the man with the whip. The man that's certainly not best friends with Ricky Santana. That's for darn sure. He's taken some Santana's hide on more than one occasion. Nice reversal by Shane. And a nice hip hop, catching the rip hop coming in. Jocko gets a taste of it. And Shane hitting and running. Ooh, nice profile there.
Back to your corner. Back to your corner.
Irwin, perhaps the most orthodox of the Irwin Militia trio. Headlock nicely applied by Shane.
Come on, Bill.
The dudes were the top teams in the NWA. Nice move there. Tag is made to Flying Bryan, the legal man. Drop kick. Oh, right in his face. Hillman with a side headlock. Walks the ropes and takes Irwin over. Flying Bryan, former member of the Cincinnati Bengals football team. Played 2 years for the Bengals, was an All-American in Miami of Ohio. Great agility. He's quite an athlete. He'll defy gravity. He's really got some great flying maneuvers. And Irwin found his shoulders on the mat for a two count there. Gilman got that side headlock. He's noticed when he got a man on the mat like he has Irwin right now that how the size differential is really meaningless. Right now, Irwin will be more effective because he's up to a vertical base. As Flying Bryan tags in Johnny. And Johnny hooks it, and Pillman nails it. Big shot. Irwin's there for the ride, and a flying elbow by Johnny of the Dude. And Irwin is in the Dude Flying Bryan part of town, and it's not a real friendly part of town for him at this point in time. Irwin trying to maneuver Johnny back to the corner. He tags in Morgan. And Rip-Hop was nailed. Nice drop kick by Johnny. Irwin nailed by Shane, and another drop kick by Johnny. And the dude's been killed. League of Man, and as is Johnny. Well, it's been a great crowd at the Great American Bash Tour. Noisy. Families coming out. Great opportunity to bring the entire family to see all the top stars our sport has to offer in one night. Plus, in many of the cities, will also see the two-ring battle royal as Shane comes off the second turnbuckle with an elbow. Shane tags in Flying Brian, who easily leaps over the top rope. Snaps down on the arm of Ripa Morgan. Morgan plants that knee. The well-developed abdomen of Flying Brian kicks him down a bear hug. And this is his strategy. Bear hug slam. One, two, and kill. Oh, he just almost got pinned. The militia and Irwin want to slow it down, no doubt. High impact as they can. Use some power moves and control the tempo. Can they do that? That's the question. Irwin's got filled up. Big side slam on Flying Brian.
You want him back? Come on. You want him back? Come on.
Former All-American from the cradle of coaches, Miami of Ohio, is in trouble. Also played for a time in the Canadian Football League for Calgary. He was a nose tackle in college, played linebacker in the pros, and has brought weight to compete in the NWA, believe it or not. Bought the foot right from Jacko's victory, right to his face. And our first extended look at Flying Brian. Quite auspicious 1-on-1 outing, but he's being kind of scared by a much larger man. And the Ripper's got to hit him off. He's going to make the tag. Morgan positioning himself between Pillman and Pillman's corner. Irish hoopsie man and a lot of velocity. Morgan positioning himself between Pillman and Pillman's corner. Irish hoopsie man and a lot of velocity. Pillman really being punished now by this much bigger man. Another Irish whip. And Morgan goes all the way to the post. And Pillman tags in Johnny. Johnny leapfrogging over. Nice drop kick. Another drop kick by Johnny. He's got Morgan in big trouble. Clothesline. Fighting right in the ugly mug. Right hand trailing. Nice reversal by Morgan. Drop down. Clothesline from the outside. A wild bill. And you heard Irwin say, get on him, get on him. The militia and Irwin, certainly the aggressor, certainly in the forefront in this one. They have the advantage. And they would like to keep Johnny in the ring for the balance of this contest, if at all possible. Irwin heading off Johnny for making the tag. Drawing in Shane, that gives a chance for the double team. And Morgan just nailed Johnny with a big left hand, big roundhouse left. And quite frankly, I don't know how much more Johnny can take of this. This is just street fighting, high impact tactics with Irwin and the militia controlling the tempo very decidedly.
Come on, young dude! Go, Johnny, go!
Goes unorthodox. Boots of Irwin. Top of the throat of Johnny. The crowd goes Johnny going. Makes a big move there. Could be the breaking knees, but look at the victory hold. His foot pulls him out of the range of making the tag. That's a smart move by Jacko. Maybe not in a sportsmanlike manner, but very intelligent and timely indeed. Flying elbow by Morgan. He'll go for the pin here. One,
two, and a kick out. Two and three quarters, at least. Tag made. Wild Bill now, the leader man. Wild Bill with a big wild right hand. They have Johnny in the center of the ring, and that may be as far as he gets to making a tag. That big knee coming off the ropes will certainly silence the crowd. It's like the visiting team making a slam dunk in basketball. It'll take the crowd, the home crowd, right back out of the game. And it has done that at this point in time in this six-man tag team event here on the National Wrestling Alliance. A great sport of professional wrestling's oldest governing body, the NWA. Johnny fighting back. This is a severe test for the dudes Van for Flying Brian, as Militia and Irwin are three big, tough, raw-boned individuals. Elbow. We said we thought it would go high impact. We said that we thought that the Militia and Irwin would slow it down, and they have. He misses with a clothesline and a double clothesline. Both men down. Jacko from the impact. Perhaps Johnny from impact and fatigue. Johnny trying to make the tag. Irwin has been tagged in. And Irwin doing all he can to keep Johnny from tagging his partner. And Johnny may have missed a golden opportunity to tag in either Flying Brian or Shane there. Johnny needs for Irwin to make a mistake. And that may be it right there. Tag is made. Here comes Flying Brian with a dropkick. Kick to the midsection. Headbutt to the back of the head. Filming now is wild and unorthodox. Takes a lot of chances. Oh, he got him right in the face. Look how high he got. All six men, I think it's Filming. And Earl, the little men, I think. Johnny back in this fight. All six men of this tag team event now are in the ring. Filming thrown outside. I think he's the legal man. Shane, though, hammered there by Irwin. When you come to a slugfest, that's not the way the dudes want to do it. These big guys are too rough in the slugfest, I think. All right. Irwin being kicked, but here comes Filming up top. Filming came all the way off the top. One, two, three. Irwin didn't see it coming. Filming, what a high left maneuver. Off the top rope. And Filming and the dudes have won it. What a spectacular move by Flying Brian. Let's take another look at it if we have the opportunity. Filming was indeed the legal man. But there you see him. We said he took a lot of chances. High risk move all the way over. Irwin lost his balance, fell right into the trap. And Filming puts the feet on the shoulders. Filming and the dudes have won it. And we'll be back on the National Wrestling Alliance.
For Barry Switzer, I'm not surprised he quit, you know.
I'll tell you what, fans, it's time now once again for my esteemed friend James E. Cornette to tell us about this week's NWA Wrestler of the Week.
Well, this week's Wrestler of the Week, he's an acrobat, he's a martial artist, he may even be a magician. He's a mean motor scooter and a bad go-getter. The Great Muta is the Wrestler of the Week this week.
And he is undefeated, ladies and gentlemen, the Great Muta. Hey, we didn't pick it. The Great Muta will be wrestling the Singer on July 23rd for the television championship. We got a big weekend tomorrow night at 6:05 and Sunday night at 6:05.
It's hot as always on the Power Hour and on TBS. And tomorrow night on World Championship Wrestling, you're going to be seeing the Danger Zone return with Paulie's special guest, Terry Funk. These guys are going to be quite an item. I'd like to take a look at that. Also, we're going to be seeing My Midnight Express against the New Zealand Militia, and we're going to kick some sheep you know what right there out of the New Zealand Militia. And then you're also going to see the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, right here on World Championship Wrestling. And don't forget Sunday, the NWA main event, both days, 6.05 p.m. Eastern time.
Let's tell them, fans, also next Friday night right here after the Braves game here on the Power Hour, we're going to show you for the first time ever in prime time a cage match involving the Road Warriors and the SST. A cage match this coming next Friday night right here on the NWA Power Hour. We won't miss that one.
I think a cage is the best place for those slobbering Samoans and their manager, Paulie. We'll see you next week.
Fans, join us tomorrow night at 6.05.